And we're getting a new look today inside the mind of Osama bin Laden. The former al-Qaeda leader kept digital files for dozens of English language books at his compound in Pakistan.
U.S. officials say he may have referenced them to understand the West. The government has released the list of books named bin Laden's bookshelf. A few of the materials in the compound included conspiracy and truther texts about 9/11, books on the CIA, volumes by MIT linguist Noam Chomsky, the book Obama's Wars by journalist Bob Woodward, and even a suicide prevention manual.
Officials say bin Laden appeared to have been very interested in conspiracy theories. In addition to reading up on 9/11, he also had books about the Bush administration, the Freemasons, the Illuminati, Pearl Harbor, and the Holocaust. They were basically broken into two lists, the non-classified and now declassified, and underneath different like media articles. For example, there were things like an LA Times article entitled, "Is Al-Qaeda Just Bush's Boogeyman?" That was from 2005. There were several Newsweek articles, some from Businessweek. And then under the miscellaneous documents that we found, there were documents titled A Map of Iran Missile Sites, Iran Nuclear Enrichment Sites, and a map of Iran nuclear sites in general.
Yeah, really a fascinating look. In addition to that, there were also some things regarding the logistics, things as common as Adobe software manuals. But also, if you go to the very first section of this now declassified material, there is what appears to be an application for people who are trying to join al-Qaeda. And this is something that I had not seen before. It asks such mundane questions as your basic information, first name, nickname, alias, but then goes on to say over the course of this, things like, do you know anyone who travels to Western countries? Do any of your family or friends work with the government? If so, would he or she be willing to cooperate with or help us? And on the last page of this, a question, do you wish to execute a suicide operation? And it's just really startling to see this interspersed with all these documents.
It is. Even that application, Elaine, it goes on to say, do you have any chronic or hereditary diseases? And then the next question, who should we contact in case you become a martyr? And it has a line for your address and your phone number. So some fascinating insight here into what's been uncovered.